Good morning, students. Welcome to EVS class. We are continuing with chapter 2, which is inside our body. In our previous video, we have already learned about liver and kidney. Now, recap time. Look at the picture here. This is our liver. It is reddish brown in color. And it is the largest and heaviest internal organ. It helps in digestion by producing digestive juice, which is called bile. Look here. These are kidneys. They are also reddish brown in color and bean shaped. We have a pair of kidneys. How kidneys help us? Our body produces different types of waste material. Kidney filter this and produce urine as a waste material. So, this was a short recapitulation. Now move toward today's topic. Today, we will looking into bones and muscles. Okay. Children, do you know our body is made up of bones and muscles which is covered with skin? Now press your right hand against your chest. What do you feel? A hard structure inside our chest. These are bones. Again touch and feel your left arm with the fingers of your right hand. The hard things in the middle is bone and the soft flesh around them are muscles. Students, every day we do a lot of work such as walking, running, playing, eating and many others. Our bones and muscles play an important role in these activities. They are responsible for all our body movement. Now, know about bones. Bones in our body forms a framework which is called skeleton. Every single person has a skeleton made up of bones. Look at the picture. It is a picture of a human skeleton. It is a framework of bone. You can see it is made up of bone fully. These bones are hard and of different shapes and sizes. For example, look at leg and hand bones. They are very long. And again, look at the bones which are present in rib cage. They are thin and they are rounded. So bones are different in shapes and sizes. Next point. Adult human has 206 bones. But a newborn baby has more than 300 bones. Gradually, many of these bones fuse together and stand at 206. Now move to our next point, which is functions of bone. How bone help us? What is the function of bone in our body? Bones hold our body up and give it support and a firm shape. It is the bones which make our body upright, which hold our body and give proper shape to our body. Next, bones protect the soft and delicate organs of our body. Means it protects all our internal organs which are inside our body. It helps in body movement. This skeleton is responsible for all our body movement. So these are the functions of bones in our body. I hope bone is clear to you. Now move to our next topic, which is muscles. Now look at the picture of muscles. These are our muscles. This fleshy structure are our muscles. Muscles are fleshy tissues which are connected to the bones by tendons. What are tissues? Tissues are mass of cells that form our body. They are mass of cells. And what are tendons? Tendons are cord-like structure, which are very strong and thin. They join the muscles to the bones. So what are muscles? Muscles are fleshy tissues which are connected to the bones by tendons. There are about 650 muscles in a human body. How many? 650 muscles we have in our body. Next, contraction and relaxation of muscles causes movement of bones. Contraction means tighten. Tighten the muscles so that bones can come closer to each other, and then relaxation, both together produce body movement so that we can walk, run, jump or play. Now move to the next point, which is functions of muscles. Muscles helps the bones to move, and muscles also give shape to our body. A well-developed body is generally comes from well-developed muscles. Muscles give a graceful appearance to our body. Next, move to did you know portion. We need 200 muscles to take just a single step. Isn't it very surprising that our single step need 200 muscles? Now one question. Where are the strongest muscle located in our body? In the jaw. Jaw muscles are the strongest muscles in our body. Now some tips to keep our bones and muscles healthy. Point 1. Regular exercise. Regular exercises keeps our bones and muscles healthy. Point 2. Maintain a good posture while you walk or sit or stand. Next, take healthy diet and take proper rest, which will help you to keep your body fit. So students, that's all for today. Hope the points are clear to you. Here we end the chapter 2. Now you have a homework. Write down all the keywords in your notebook from this chapter. I will provide the keywords as a PDF form. Next day, we will do the exercises of this chapter. Thank you.